Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to this Power Word Simulator tutorial. Today I am going to teach you how to perform economic load dispatch including losses in the Power Word Simulator software. For this purpose, I have taken an example from the book Power System Analysis by Hadi Sadat, Chapter 7, Example 7.10. Consider the example which consists of 5 bus power system having generators at bus 1, 2 and 3. The bus voltages and other data is given as shown in the figure. The generation cost functions of the 3 power plants are given in the following equations, where P1, P2 and P3 are the power supplied by 3 power plants in megawatt. We have to find the optimal dispatch of generation, total cost and losses when the generators have the following minimum and maximum real power limits. Now I am going to perform the economic load dispatch including the power losses in the Power Word Simulator. Let's start. Just click on this icon to open the Power Word Simulator software. Click on this icon to open a new model. For better visibility, go to the option and click on Draw Grid. Change the grid horizontal and vertical to 2 and click on Draw Grid Lines in order to make them visible here. Just look at the figure. It consists of 5 bus power system. Therefore, first we have to put 5 buses. For this purpose, go to Draw and click on Network, then click on Bus and insert it anywhere on the screen. A window will appear, write here Bus 1. Click on Bus Information. It asks about the bus voltage. From the example data, the voltage for Bus 1 is 1.06 per unit and this bus is considered a slack bus. Therefore, write here 1.06. Click on System Select Bus and press OK. Similarly, repeat the same procedure to put the bus 2. Write here bus 2. From the example data, the voltage for bus 2 is 1.045 per unit. Therefore, write here 1.045 and press OK. Similarly, repeat the same procedure to put the bus 3. Write here bus 3. Click on bus information. It asks about the bus voltage. From the example data, the voltage for bus 3 is 1.03 per unit. Therefore, write here 1.03 and press OK. Similarly, repeat the same procedure to put the bus 4 and 5. As bus 4 and 5 are load buses, therefore, write their voltages to 1 per unit. Now we have to put the generators. For this purpose, go to Draw and click on Network, then click on Generator and insert it at bus 1. A window will appear. Go to Display and click on Down. Now click on Power and Voltage Control. It asks about the generator power and its limits. From the example data, the minimum and maximum power limits for first generator are 10 and 85 megawatt respectively. Therefore, write here 10, again 10, and here 85. Change this participation factor from 10 to 1. As the voltage of bus 1 is 1.06 per unit, therefore, write set point voltage to 1.06 again. Now click on cost block, then click on output cost model, then click on cubic cost model to put the cost function variables. For this purpose, look at the example data. The variable for the first power plant are 7, 0.008 and 200. Therefore, write here 7, here 0.008, here 200 and press OK. Remove this reactive power block and double click on this active power block. Write 1 in delta per mouse click and 4 in digit to right of decimal and press OK. Similarly, put the second generator and connect it at bus 2. Look at the figure again. Generator 2 is supplying active power of 40 megawatt. whereas its minimum and maximum power limits are 10 and 80 megawatt respectively. Therefore, write here 40, here 10 and 80 here. Change this participation factor from 10 to 1. As the voltage of bus 2 is 1.045 per unit, therefore write set point voltage to 1.045 again here. Now click on cast block, then click on output cast model, then click on cubic cast model to put the cast function variables. Look at the example data again. The variables for second power plant are 6.3, 0.009, and 180. Therefore, write here 6.3, here 0.009, here 180, and press OK. Remove this reactive power block and double click on this active power block. Write 1 in delta per mouse click and 4 in digit to right of decimal and press OK. Similarly, put the third generator and connect it at bus 3. Go to display and click on down. Look at the figure again. Generator 3 is supplying active power of 30 megawatt, whereas its minimum and maximum power limits are 10 and 70 megawatt respectively. Therefore, write here 30, here 10, and 70 here. Change this participation factor from 10 to 1. As the voltage of bus 3 is 1.03 per unit, therefore write set point voltage to 1.03 again here. Now click on cast block, then click on output cast model, then click on cubic cast model to put the cast function variables. Look at the example data. The variables for third power plant are 6.8, 0.007 and 140. Therefore, write here 6.8, here 0.007, here 140 and press OK. Remove this reactive power block and double click on this active power block. Write 1 in delta per mouse click and 4 in digit to right of decimal and press OK. Now we need to connect the transmission lines. For this purpose, go to draw, click on transmission line and connect it from bus 1 to bus 2. Look at the figure again. From bus 1 to bus 2, the transmission line has 0.02, 0.06 and 0.03 values of resistance, reactance and capacitive susceptance respectively. Therefore, write here 0.02, here 0.06 and here 0.03. Go to display, change the pixel thickness size to 3 and press OK. Double click on this meter, click on this pie chart options, change the color if you want, I choose blue in this case. Click on total power option and press OK. Write 10,000 here in the MVA rating and press OK. Now we need to connect the transmission line between bus 1 and bus 3. Again, take the transmission line and connect between these two buses. Look at the figure again. From bus 1 to bus 3, the transmission line has 0.08, 0.24 and 0.025 values of resistance, reactance and capacitive susceptance respectively. Therefore, write here 0.08, here 0.24 and here 0.025. Go to display, change the pixel thickness size to 3 and press OK. Double click on this meter and write 10,000 here in the MVA rating and press OK. Now we need to connect the transmission line between bus 2 and bus 3. Again, take the transmission line and connect between these two buses. Look at the figure again. From bus 2 to bus 3, the transmission line has the 0.06, 0.18 and 0.02 values of resistance, reactance and capacitive susceptance respectively. Therefore, write here 0.06, here 0.18 and here 0.02. Go to display, change the pixel thickness size to 3 and press OK. Double click on this meter and write 10,000 here in the MVA rating and press OK. Now we need to connect the transmission line between bus 2 and bus 4. Again take the transmission line and connect between these two buses. Look at the figure again. From bus 2 to bus 4, the transmission line has the 0.06, 0.18 and 0.02 values of resistance, reactance and capacitive susceptance respectively. Therefore, write here 0.06, here 0.18 and here 0.02. Go to display, change the pixel thickness size to 3 and press OK. Double click on this meter and write 10,000 here in the MVA rating and press OK. Now we need to connect the transmission line between bus 2 and bus 5. Again take the transmission line and connect between these two buses. Look at the figure again. From bus 2 to bus 5, the transmission line has the 0.04, 0.12 and 0.015 values of resistance, reactance and capacitive susceptance respectively. Therefore, write here 0.04, here 0.12 and here 0.015. Go to display, change the pixel thickness size to 3 and press OK. Double click on this meter and write 10,000 here in the MVA rating and press OK. Now we need to connect the transmission line between bus 3 and bus 4. Again take the transmission line and connect between these two buses. Look at the figure again. From bus 3 to bus 4, the transmission line has the 0.01, 0.03 and 0.01 values of resistance, reactance and capacitive susceptance respectively. Therefore, write here 0.01, here 0.03 and here 0.01. Go to display, change the pixel thickness size to 3 and press OK. Double click on this meter and write 10,000 here in the MVA rating. Now we need to connect the transmission line between bus 4 and bus 5. Again take the transmission line and connect between these two buses. Look at the figure again. From bus 4 to bus 5, the transmission line has the 0.08, 0.24 and 0.025 values of resistance, reactance and capacitive susceptance respectively. Therefore, write here 0.08, here 0.24 and here 0.025. Go to display, change the pixel thickness size to 3 and press OK. Double click on this meter and write 10,000 here in the MVA rating. Now we need to put the measurement blocks in the model. For this purpose, go to field, click on bus field and put it here at bus 1. Write here 1.06 to represent the voltage in per unit, 4 here in digits to write off the decimal and press OK. Similarly, repeat the procedure to represent the per unit voltage at bus 2. Write here 1.045, here 4 in digits to write off decimal and press OK. Similarly, repeat the procedure to represent the per unit voltage at bus 3. Write here 1.03, here 4 in digits to write off decimal and press OK. Similarly, repeat the same procedure to represent the per unit voltage at bus 4 and bus 5. As bus 4 and 5 are load buses, therefore write their voltage to 1 per unit. Now go to field again, click on transmission line field and click here to represent the active power flow from bus 1 to bus 3. Similarly, repeat the procedure to put the active power flows at all points. Now we need to connect the load. Take the load from here and connect it here at bus 2. A window will appear. Change the orientation to down. It may be noted from the example data that the active and reactive load at bus 2 is 20 MW and 10 MVAR respectively. Therefore, write 20 here, 10 here and press OK. Now we need to connect the load at bus 3. Therefore, take the load from here and connect it here at bus 3. A window will appear. Change the orientation to up. It may be noted from the example data that active and reactive load at bus 3 is 20 MW and 15 MVAR respectively. Therefore, write 20 here, 15 here and press OK. Now we need to connect the load at bus 4. Therefore, take the load from here and connect it here at bus 4. A window will appear. It may be noted from the example data that the active and reactive load at bus 4 is 50 MW and 30 MVAR respectively. Therefore, write 50 here, 30 here and press OK. Now we need to connect the load at bus 5. Therefore, take the load from here and connect it here at bus 5. A window will appear. It may be noted from the example data that the active and reactive load at bus 5 is 60 MW and 40 MVAR respectively. Therefore, write 60 here, 40 here and press OK. Now we need to initialize the automatic generation control mode for generators. For this purpose, go to field, then click on generator field and put it here at generator 1. A window will appear. Click on generator AGC status and press OK. You will see that AGC mode is activated. Similarly, repeat the procedure to activate the AGC mode for the remaining two other generators. Now we have to activate the economic load dispatch mode in order to perform the optimal dispatch of generators. For this purpose, go to case information, then aggregation, click on areas, change this off AGC mode to economic dispatch mode. Now we need to find the total cost per hour for this model. For this purpose, go to field, click on area field and put it anywhere on the screen. Click on hourly cost and press OK to measure the total cost. To write its heading, go to background, click on text and put it anywhere on the screen. Write here total hourly cost and press OK. Now repeat the same procedure to measure the total load in megawatt for the whole area. Again, bring the text box, write here total load and press OK. Similarly, repeat the same procedure to measure the total losses in megawatt for the whole area. Again, bring the text box, write here megawatt losses and press OK. Last, we have to measure the incremental fuel cost per hour for this example. For this purpose, go to field, then area field and click on select a field. Then from the pop-up menu, scroll down and select OPF/Lambda and press OK. Again, bring the text box, write here incremental cost and press OK. Friends, at this stage our model is complete. Now you can run the simulation. For this purpose, click on this run mode, go to tool and click on play button. You can see it has successfully performed the economic load dispatch. Now compare the losses measured by the software with the losses obtained in the example. You can see the losses obtained by the software are quite high. However, it is not bad. I will show you within few seconds. Now compare the incremental cost measured by the software with the cost obtained in the example. You can see, despite of high losses, the incremental cost measured by the software is still quite low compared to the cost obtained in the example. This is interesting. Actually, economic load dispatch belongs to the optimization problem. In this optimization problem, our aim is to find the minimum cost in order to make the economic load dispatch cheaper. For this purpose, various methods are used to find the optimum dispatch of generators with minimum cost. Therefore, in this example, it is observed that the software has obtained more economical cost compared to the cost obtained in the example despite of higher losses. Similarly, you can compare the total hourly cost of the economic load dispatch with the answer obtained in the example. You can see the cost measured by the software is quite low compared to the cost obtained in the example. Finally, compare the optimal dispatch of generators answer with the answer obtained in the example. You can see all the power supplied by the generators in the software are quite different than the answer obtained in the example. It is because in economic load dispatch, various combinations of the generators are possible. Therefore, this software determines the one of the best combination resulting in the minimum cost. Friends, in this tutorial, I have discussed how to perform economic load dispatch including the generator limits as well as losses in PowerWatt simulator software. By doing the same way, any power system can be designed in PowerWatt simulator software and its economic load dispatch can be performed. I would like to strongly recommend all of you to take IEEE 9 bus system data and try it to build in PowerWatt simulator software and perform its economic load dispatch. Similarly, you can design IEEE 14 bus test system, IEEE 30 bus test system, IEEE 69 bus test system, and so on. Performing the economic load dispatch of these IEEE systems can be used as an objective for your bachelor degree final year project as well as one of the research objective of your master degree research. That's all for today's tutorial. I hope you really enjoyed this tutorial. Friends, I upload many videos based on various topics of power system and motivation on regular basis. Therefore, don't forget to subscribe my channel in order not to miss my latest videos. And don't forget to share my videos with your friends and class fellows so that they can also get benefit from these videos. Thank you very much.